From Beijing Institute of Technology. Today I'm going to make a presentation in the field of a digital holographic display based on analytic method. Okay, we can see here's a picture is taken from the website called futuretimeline.net. It makes some prediction in 100 years later in 2000, in 22 centuries, is a technology is based on holographic display called some personal holographic devices. It can provide some possibility to make some display just in front of a person without any some physical fixing. And just like some people come touching the air. So comparing the technology now, people do the touching screen. I think this should be the final fantasy of the holographic display in the future. Okay, before I go to my subject, I would like to make a brief introduction to my university, Beijing Institute of Technology, short as BIT. BIT is located in Beijing, the capital of China. It is established in 1940, has a history of nearly 70 years old. The BIT is a subject is mainly focused in the science and technology, especially for the application in the engineering and the militaries. The School of Optoelectronics is one of the most oldest and the biggest school colleges in BIT, and it has very long history and courses and research in the field of optical engineering. It covering the field from optical design, fabrication, testing, and some laser optics to the field of physical optics, nano optics, and nearly almost covering the almost a field in optical engineering. The subject rank for the BIT in the field of optical engineering is always in the top among this field in China. So it's a very good place to study optics, I think. So my presentation will begin from the introduction to mini projectors. And following that will be the origin of this job. And the theory and the systems will be discussed. And finally, the results from the experiment and the conclusion will be given. First off, I'm going to talk something about mini projectors, which is a very popular topic in the projection technology in recent couple of years. So the first prototype mini projectors with portable dimensions, also with a very low power consumption, is submitted in Israel in 2003. And as we can see from these pictures, it's the dimension size is just like a pencil box, it's just a little thick. And it uses laser diode source and transmitted spatial light modulators and some kind of illumination lenses. And modifications are made on the spatial light modulators to make possibility of the higher display brightness. And also the modification is made on the illumination lenses. As we can see from here, a green, black, and monochromatic image can be displayed with a power consumption only less than 3 watt, which makes possibility to drive these small devices by a normal battery for the mobile phone, compared with the conventional projector, which is have a power consumption is more than 300 volts. 3 years later, in 2006, just a real-time projector is demonstrated by a team leading by Professor Crossland in Cambridge and also with Core Maker's Alpus company. Just like in this adult's hand, it can provide full colors, 24-bit at the 60 hertz rate, and so based on Alcor's chip. The laser light source is used, and it can achieve the optical efficiency is more than 40%, and achieve a resolution to 640 plus 480. As we can see here, there's a real-time and full-color display. The BAO2 mini projector is all based on the laser holographic technologies, which is a recent very popular. Compared with the conventional projector technologies, which is show we can see here. It's very small one, just like in the mobile phone size. It is conventional technologies using 3M mini LCOS project engine. And it can achieve the 10 lumen brightness for the display. And it's illuminated by a LED light source. And also can achieve the resolution in the VGA. And it also can support some SD card or USB as a connection. And 1 GB internal flash memory is inside. As we can see here, the people is holding this as a mini projector and project the image on just the table. If we make a comparison between these two as a mini project technologies, so one side is a very popular laser holographic projection technology. The other one is very is a conventional one as a projections. We can find some advantages for the former one. For the holographic screen projector technologies, it can achieve very high optical efficiency. This is, I think, the main purpose for the technology. And also, it can achieve very short display distance because it's using diffraction theories compared with the normal with the conventional project technologies. And also, it can use very fewer components. But it also has a drawback of more computation times. Because for holographic displays, for example, we have an image here. We want to display. Before we do the display, we have to calculate the phase distribution to be uploaded on the spatial light modulators. And this process is called phase retrieval, as we all know. And the process between these two is a standard Fourier transform. And among the many is a phase retrieval methods, the GES is a very old and standard one, and it has many improvement additions. But the problem is, if we want to achieve very high image qualities, we need many internal GES calculations. It means we need a very strong CPUs, maybe we need many computers. So the computation cost is higher, so the power supply is also higher. We cannot integrate such a huge system in a portable size to holding in your hand. So the trade-off is have to be made between the computation time and the image qualities. So we are thinking about if you can find a method to achieve very good, nearly theoretically perfect image quality, and also we can have very low computation cost and power supply. So this is the origin of this job. In November of 2008, there's a postgraduate student of Capital Normal University in China has submitted a paper about an optical image encryption methods based on the interference. So it's a totally new architecture. It's using two phase-only masks, as we can see, M1 and M2. The light is transmitted as a phase mask is modulated. And then using a half mirror to combine these two as a wavefront to interfere in output plane to achieve a decryption of the image. So here's a numerical simulation for these systems. As we can see, this one is the original image, but this one is the decoded image. And it is very hard to find some difference between these two. So it says that the decoded image is nearly perfect. The below two this figure is the phase distribution for the two phase only masks. The drawback for this system is that it has very high sensitivities depending on the deviation of the illumination wavelengths and optical alignment. So it is only possible in the digital optical image encryption. If we can't get rid of this sensitivity, maybe we can make use of it in the holographic display in the future. So this is the improvement we made. We made some modifications to shift the interference from the Fresnel domain to Fourier domain. We just add a Fourier lenses between the systems. So the sensitivity can be lower to be an acceptable level. and make the holographic display possible. So here is the equations and how we can find the analytic formation for the face masks. As we can see, it's a very simple steps. Everyone can use a pen and a paper. It take 10 minutes to find out. And the further improvement is also made to combine these two face masks into only one. Because following the further architectures, we need two spatial light modulators to achieve the holographic display. It increase the cost and also make some difficulty in the optical alignment. So if we made some modifications to integrate these two face masks into only one, as you can see here, the method we find out is to add a linear tilt phase factors to change the face mask M1 into M1 dot. So here's the experiment result. In a moment, the method is not so perfect, so we need to improve it a little. Okay, and the last bit to conclusion is a new digital holographic display architecture is presented. It's based on non-iterative algorithm, and it has a very less computation time and has the possibility of the very high display qualities that need to be smart mobile work in the future. And does not need further optimization in the future. And I'm going to thank my supervisor as an acknowledgement. Professor Xie Jinghui and Professor Liu Juan and all my teammates. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Nan.
So here's a picture I take in Monday with Professor TJ and the three of my team workers. This is my supervisor, and this is these two boys is my teammates. Thank you.
Are there any questions for Nan? I have a real quick one. What was the feature size of your LCOS, your phase display device?
Reflective one.
Yes. What was the feature size? What were the size of the
feature size is about 15 microns.
So do you think if you had a smaller feature size device that would improve some of the characteristics? Give you
yeah, exactly. So if you're using the HoloEye, the company is a spatial light modulator. It has 8 microns as a pixel size. Can be as more smooth and more as resolutions.
Well, thank you. Any other questions?